Welcome to our Keywords Tracker training video. In this video, we're going to cover how to use the Keyword Tracker tool in your Managed by Stats account. You simply enter an ASIN, and then you enter your own list of keywords that you'd want to track. We'll refer to each ASIN as a project. To add a new ASIN, click the Add ASIN button. You then get an entry screen for the new ASIN. For the name field, simply give the product a name that will allow you to easily identify it. This name is for your use only. Then enter the ASIN. If you want a set of keywords evaluated for more than one ASIN in a single project, you can add multiple ASINs in this field by separating them with a comma. For instance, if you had a bunch of variations that you wanted checked together. You'll notice the selection Include Child ASINs is checked by default. So child ASINs will be included by default for all projects unless unchecked. Also note that you can enter a child ASIN in the ASINs field, and the system will include all related ASINs. In other words, if the ASIN you put in the ASIN field is a child ASIN, and the Include Child ASINs box is checked, it will include all other child ASINs for the related ASIN you listed. An important note on this is that the Keywords tool will only work for ASINs that have a functional or active listing on Amazon. If you use an ASIN in the ASINs field that is not live on Amazon currently, the system will warn you and will not be able to pull rankings. You can create a project for any ASIN, which means you can also create projects to monitor competitor ASINs as well. Once you've selected your ASINs, select the country or the marketplace for this ASIN. Next, you have three fields where you can select your tiers for color separation on the summary grid. The summary grid is the columns and rows of performance results you see when looking at keywords for any ASIN. Color coding can be helpful for at-a-glance evaluation of how particular keywords are doing. You simply specify the ranges, number of items per color, and after you save the project, you can also change the colors to your preference down here. For these tiers, you simply determine how many positions you'd want for each color, as different categories have different amounts of products per page. So you could have tier 1 color for page 1 and tier 2 for page 2, etc. Or if you have many keywords somewhere on page 1, you could also set this to have the first color be positions 1 through 15 or 1 through 10 or any other combination thereof. Later, when looking at the summary grid, you'll see where these colors come into play. In the final field, you can simply add your keywords. You can type them in one at a time or paste them in as a list. We automatically include the keyword search frequency rank for any search terms that are in the top million search terms on Amazon. Click here at the bottom to save the project. As mentioned, you can edit a project at any time by clicking the Edit button here. Once you've added a project, the system begins to pull rank info for that ASIN for all the keywords. This happens automatically, and any new keywords you add in will be updated overnight. Let's take a look at a project that's been added and has rank info for keywords. When looking at any project, the default view is the summary grid. The summary grid is where you see the numeric results color-coded according to the colors you selected. This is an easy way to see at a glance how your keywords are doing. Columns are organized by date, with the most recent date on the left, the first column, with each column after that representing the previous day going back in time. Each row is a keyword, and to the left of each keyword is a small graph, giving you a visual representation of the trend for that keyword. You can then click an individual keyword to see detailed info. In the detail screen for an individual keyword, the graph will show you how that keyword has been doing historically, and you can also sort by a variety of date range options. Below the graph is a grid for that keyword, with additional info like number of reviews, star rating, price, BSR, etc. There's also an additional field to enter notes, which will display on the graph so you can track changes or other factors that may affect your keyword ranking. Click back to summary to go back to the summary grid. You can also sort the keywords for a given project. Click the sort button and you're given the option to sort by keyword rank, alphabetically, search volume, or a custom option to drag and drop the keywords into a desired position. You can also sort the ASINs or projects alphabetically, by BSR, or with a custom drag and drop. And if you have a ton of ASINs you're tracking, you can also search for the one you want with the search option here. If you want to delete an entire project, select the project and click this button to delete it. You'll be asked to confirm deleting the project to make sure this is what you want to do. This will delete the entire project and all keywords in the project, and the historical data will no longer be available. And that covers all the features of the Keyword Tracker tool.